Wouldn't advise going inside. Not with your reputation for depravity and general aversion to the law, in all seriousness. Your countenance is quite discernible, and there are certain of my consociates who would take it upon themselves to exercise their right to lethal force were they to encounter you in person. But it's good to cross paths with you again, my friend. After head of security at the Diamond, this isn't exactly what I had in mind, but it's still a long way from a mall cop, right? Let's take a walk. Relax. I'm a cop, but I'm not a cop. This is just where the universe put me right now. I mean, I have my path and you have yours. And quite frankly, I don't give a damn about your antics out there. I mean, check this out. You see that misguided individual? How do you think he's gotten away with selling drugs in front of that burger shop very conspicuously for 10 years now? In front of the largest department in the city. He cuts them in.
Effenberger, you copy? Yo, Effenberger.
I copy.
Worst last name ever, dude. I mean, effing what? Anyway, when you got five, we all need some effing coffee down here on Dick's. And don't forget the effing cream and sugar.
Copy that. I'm out here getting coffee for cops on the take. There's a new cartel running a large-scale cocaine operation out of the Cluckin' Bell factory in Palito Bay. And being no doubt, the cops? They're not only turning a blind eye, they're actively facilitating. If you ask me, the cartel and the cops can both go to hell, preferably on the back of the same bullet. I'm talking about a surgical strike, man. Taking out the whole operation. That's why I came to you. Let's go somewhere a bit more unfrequented. If you raid that factory, anything you find is yours to keep. This is about these assholes running the biggest protection racket in the state. That's the kind of status quo I cannot abide. As far as my part, I can provide all the intel you need. Records, names, locations. We will need to educate ourselves on the factory, though. Gather materials so you can attack it with style and aptitude.
Ding fucking dong, Officer Effenberger. We're effing falling asleep over here. Get us some effing coffee.
Copy that. I'm on my way. Can I count you in? Excellent. Now on to the first order of business. Acquire some funds. I suggest we take a more proactive stance. Time to do what you do. I'll call you.
Hey, you read me? Dropping you the location shortly. These are all businesses known for money laundering. You know, I have dreams about working at the Diamond again. And then I find myself by the lucky wheel and realize I am unexplainably without pains. My loose interpretation has something to do with the maintenance of authority. I invite you to consider this as a double investment opportunity. A chance to raise the funds we need to go toe-to-toe with the cartel cop coalition. And as a bonus, you get to disrupt some of your more unsavory competitors. They're on to you. Stay vigilant. Okay, pure simplicity. Get inside.
Yo,
get the money.
Fall back.
Get out. Thank you. giant processing facility for the cartel. Every other Clark and Bell van you see in town has a brick of coke under the mega mills. And of course, corrupt elements of the LSPD were only too eager to get cut in. Ingenious, right? But they think they got this whole thing sewn up. And that's where we come in. That was some admirable work, officer.
Fuck, man!
I've just marked a local garage on your GPS. Once upon a time, it was an FIB facility, then LSPD for a while. Now it's disused and wonderfully off the radar. A perfect storage locker for our operation, in my strictly humble opinion. Got it. This is a solid fund to use on the rest of our planning efforts. The first leg of which I'll get to work on right now. I'll be in touch.
Oh, come on, last night was off the hook.
All right, let's discuss a potential way into this place. The cartel are paying off employees of Cluck and Bell to use their factory as a cover. There are a couple things we'll need in order to solidify my current infiltration plan. Let's move. Sending some coordinates your way. I have a checklist for today's operation. Number one, a laptop from a Cluck and Bell employee on the cartel's payroll. It's got critical intel for our operation. Number two, a hacking device which is going to help us pilot a train. And that brings me to number three. We need a train. That's how we're getting into the factory. By the way, don't worry. We may share a goal, but I'm fully aware we do not share a motivation. I've made sure sufficient funds are allocated to recompense you for your efforts today. Okay, let's get the guy with the laptop. This is a critical piece of intel. The cartel have paid off multiple Cluck and Bell employees to look the other way while they use their business as a cover for the manufacture and distribution of cocaine. This laptop's gonna give us a window into their schedules. I just sent you a CCTV image of the guy.
Call me back the next day!
Oh. That's him. Can you locate the laptop?
Hijo de tu puta madre, piece of shit!
Excellent. This should tell us exactly when we need to hit the factory. All right, let's get ourselves a hacking device. If we're gonna do this, there's a lot of computer systems we're gonna need to override along the way, and this is our ticket. Now, fair warning, the guy who owns this is a pretty serious criminal element. Major hacker. The LSPD won't touch him, but we will. He operates out of a terabyte command truck. I'm sending you a picture of it now. My advice to you is, locate his drones. They're tethered to his security. Take them down before you proceed. I heard this guy's been living out here on the DL. Not easy in a truck stacked with so much tech, it has its own gravitational pull.
Ah! home.
Once you found the keys, the train should be at your disposal. I don't suppose you're familiar with the schematics of the train signal network. Then just follow the instructions on the hacking device to change the signals as you approach them. You need to keep that train moving at all costs. If you miss your shot, the emergency brakes will kick in and you'll be sitting ducks. Has been discreetly relocated into storage, where it will remain until the day of the raid. Things are coming together. Next on the to-do list, acquiring weapons and gear, or the getaway vehicle. Your choice. So, we have some important yet enjoyable decisions to make. On the one hand, you need to acquire your preferred weapons and gear. On the other, you need to acquire your getaway vehicle. We'll need to steal both. These can't be traced back to us. Where would you like to start? Okay, the coordinates should be with you shortly. Some surveillance images should be coming through now. These are our targets. As I'm sure you know, our operation requires weapons and gear that can't be traced back to us. The good news is that this city is crawling with gangs carrying that kind of contraband. Half of them in cahoots with this very police department. So today we're gonna confiscate one cache of weapons and one stash of gear. If any of it ends up getting traced after our raid, it'll lead to these reprobates instead of us. I've sent you the coordinates of some appropriate targets. You don't need to hit them all. My advice is to investigate your options. Determine which gang is gonna have a loadout that suits your preferences, and prioritize accordingly. As I was saying earlier, we need weapons and we need equipment. That's armor and masks. I've read this group's file several times over. Seems they run a tight operation, not to be underestimated. We're not talking military levels of security. But they're no petty criminals either, so watch your six. SPD field manual states, untraceable weapons and gear are textbook stratagem in any successful raid. When we're done here, the next step is to acquire a getaway vehicle in a similar manner. Looks like we got enough to hit the factory. Good. I'll arrange for any extras to be stashed in case you change your mind. Now that you've secured all the weapons and gear necessary to take on a clucking bell factory overrun by the cartel, we should discuss your means of escape.
Howdy, how are you?
What do you mean?
What is the deal with this life invader?
Next up, acquiring a getaway vehicle. We need to take the same precautions we did for the weapons. We steal it from a gang, so the trail leads to them instead of us. Right. Sending the locations of three viable getaway vehicles. I'm sure you have plenty of vehicles capable of getting you out of Clucking Bell with all your extremities intact. But we need something that can't be traced to us. I've acquired three suitable options for a getaway car. All of them are sourced from local gangs bribing the LSPD to turn a blind eye to their activities. If the car ends up getting traced, the trail leads back to them, not us. We'll only need to use one of them for the raid. If you return to one of them, they'll surely be ready for a repeat offense. See that chopper? It's transporting our vehicle. Shoot it down. And don't worry, this ride is tough. They can take the fall.
So I understand that your MO is up to you, but there are steps you can take to ensure the element of surprise is on your side. Introducing a little chaos into the cartel supply line is one of them. If you do, they'll assume your arrival on the train is just an unscheduled delivery. And if nothing else, the looks on their faces will be highly amusing.
To the Clucking Bell outlet on Innocence Boulevard. All right, the time has come to throw the cartel supply lines into disarray. We need them in a state of chaos. So when our unscheduled train delivery arrives at the factory, they just wave it through. So our primary objective is to locate their depot and sabotage their fleet of delivery trucks. Our secondary objective is to find a key card that'll allow us access to the factory's restricted areas. And keep an eye out for a driver uniform. That can come in handy for getting into the depot to hit the trucks. Okay, remember that laptop you got me? I found a schedule on it that says there should be delivery vans leaving this establishment any minute. Hack all the vans, and we can use the GPS to find the depot where they load up the drugs. Did you think that hacking device only works on train signals? No way! This is some multi-purpose apparatus. Let's put the GPS. Stay vigilant. If we hack additional vans, we can patch the information. If you see a uniform, take it. Might as well buy some time by playing the part. Plus, it's a rare chance to express your theatrical side.
What the fuck?
What is that?
Don't worry about the van's drivers warning their collaboration is at the garage. They won't suspect this is part of a coordinated attack. They'll just assume it's another day in Los Santos. You in that uniform? If so, you should be at an advantage. Okay, keep things quiet and this will be easy. Means the factory won't be expecting us at all. All you gotta do is sabotage the trucks and grab a key card. If you wipe the CCTV, they'll be none the wiser. But listen, if you wanna blow the trucks up, there's no way of keeping that on the down low. You'll be alerting the whole cartel that you're coming for them. But hey, maybe that's your style. Even in that getup, they'll still lose their cool if you're spotted wandering into the more sensitive parts of the building. You've been compromised. Take out those guards immediately or they'll report you to the cartel.
Take cover!
You know the Chapines?
Fuck him, football.
I'm down.
CCTV's right. As far as the cartel know, you were never here. I admire your dedication to clandestine tactics. It will be a major asset when we hit the factory. Pleasure to inform you that we have officially completed all necessary preparations to move forward with the Clucking Bell operation at your earliest convenience. Let's make this happen. How you doing in that box? Under the circumstances, your customary silence is a little concerning. Should I have added air holes? Cluck twice if you're in trouble. Okay, good. Now remember, burst out of that crate, you'll be in the heart of that operation. How you choose to use the element of surprise is up to you. This is it. Good luck. I suggest you split up once inside the factory. One party should see to the cocaine, and the other loots the safe.
Hell! Ain't no way to go.
They're mobilizing. Be advised. Stealth is no longer an option. Don't forget the extra gear your crew procured. Feel free to experiment. It should be in a dumpster to the rear of the factory. You see? It pays to befriend your local garbage man.
One down.
clear this place is barely functioning as a chicken factory. One would assume we'd have more cook and bell staff to keep up appearances, but I underestimated just how bold criminals can be once they have the police in their pocket. The key card you acquired should grant you access to restricted areas in the factory, including the basement.
Yeah, look at those fucking pieces of shit. Yeah, you're fucking dead now. Hey, put those down, you freaking hurt.
Whatever it takes to get you back to the lockup alone with the deliverables. The cartel and associated cops will process just how severely their operation's been sabotaged. No cocaine, no cash, and nobody to blame. And look at you cleaning up this town. Halfway to being an employee of the LSPD, huh? If you pocketed some of that cocaine for yourself, you'd practically be a ranked officer. They've fallen behind. In case you were wondering what I intend to do with the illegal narcotics you've so adroitly seized, I've made arrangements with the representative of a local businessman to take them off your hands and pay you well. See you shortly. My stomach's growling. It's most assuredly the daughter of two number nines. That delicious deep-fried meat paste makes me weak.
Excellent work. Mission accomplished. Now to the vital matter of payment. As I'm sure you can appreciate, there are certain transactions I can't be party to as an officer of the law. But if I've learned anything from my consociates on the LSPD, it's how to look the other way. Now remember, as far as I'm concerned, you can hit that factory as often as you'd like. As long as you're giving me reasons to keep looking the other way, I'm happy. As you can see from my choice of transportation, my fortunes at the LSPD are also improving. Just got these babies in, fresh off the line. Guess who picked one up? Until next time, let's disassociate. There's a new cartel running a large-scale cocaine operation out of the Cluckin' Bell factory in Palito Bay. And being no doubt, the cops? Can I count you in? Excellent. Now on to the first order of business. Acquire some funds. I suggest we take a more proactive stance. Time to do what you do. I'll call you.